Hello children, please use your earphones to listen to the explanation. As you all know about basic structure of plant, let's now something more about plants. So now here we are going to learn about three topics: reproduction in plants, parts of seeds and seed dispersal. Let's start with reproduction in plants. Like human beings and animals, plants also reproduce. They reproduce in different ways, like through seeds and through their body parts such as stem, leaves or root. The most common method of reproduction is through seeds. But not all seeds produced by plant can grow into new plants. Only the seeds that get favorable conditions. Now what are these favorable conditions? Yeah, you guessed it right. Favorable conditions for plants are air, water and sunlight for their growth. And a new plant can only be grown if these conditions are right. The process is called germination. You can go through about it in page number 280. Let's move on to next slide. It shows us reproduction from seeds. Now the term comes germination. What do you mean by germination? Seeds that survive and get favorable conditions such as air, water and sunlight for their growth can only grow into new plants, and the process is called germination. Now as I told you that we'll learn about three parts today. Now let's come to the next part, that is parts of a seed. Parts of a seed, it has three main parts. Those are seed coat, embryo and cotyledon. Let's start with the outermost covering of the seed, which is seed coat. A seed coat is a protective covering formed outside the seed. This protective covering safeguards in the internal structure of the seed against damage caused by pests and other animals. It also protects the seed against harsh weather conditions such as excessive heat or winter and excessive water intake. Now let's see the next part. You can see in the seed that white portion, that is a cotyledon. A cotyledon is a significant part of the embryo within the seed of the plant. It provides nourishment to the embryo until it begins to grow. Often when the seed germinates or begins to grow, the cotyledon may become the first leaves of the seedlings. Now here I will also like to tell you about cotyledon. We have two types, monocots and dicots. Monocots are the seed with one cotyledon, which you can see in rice, and dicots are seeds with two cotyledon, which you can see in beans. Now we'll come to third part, that is embryo. Embryo has again two parts. One is plumule, which is yellow in color, you can see in the figure, and then the green one, which is radicle. Now what is plumule and what is radicle? Plumule is the part of the embryo that grows above the soil, and radicle is the part of the seed or the embryo which grows below the soil. So we can also say that plumule make leaves and radicle makes root. Now let's start with dispersal of seeds. Now you must be wondering why the dispersal of seed is required and why it is necessary. Now plants produce seeds to reproduce. They do so because they are fixed to the ground and cannot move from one place to another. If all the seeds fall and grow near mother plant, they won't get enough sunlight, water, nutrients and space. That is why nature helps in scattering the seeds and ensure that they do not grow too close to each other. The process by which seeds are scattered away from their parent plant is called seed dispersal. You all must have seen different types of small plants arising from the soil. Did you ever think how these plants grow and how the seeds are dispersed? Now let me tell you, dispersal of seeds takes place by wind, explosion, water and by animals. Let's start with the You can read about agents of dispersal: dispersal by wind, dispersal by water, dispersal by animals, and dispersal by explosion. Let's start with dispersal by wind. The wind is the natural means of seed dispersal in the plant kingdom. The process of dispersal is mainly seen in those plants which bear very light seeds. Seeds are simply blown about and land in all kind of places. Seeds that are very small and light in weight are usually carried by wind. You can say the examples are cotton and dandelions. Now, there are some seeds which have wing-like structures that help them to float in the air. Seeds of plants such as drumstick, jacaranda and maple have wings which helps them to float in air. Now come to the next slide, which is dispersal by water. Seeds of the plant that grow in or near flowing water are generally dispersed by water. Many plants have seeds that use water as means of dispersal. The seeds of plants like lotus fruit is spongy and floats easily. Coconut has fibrous outer covering with air trapped between its fibers. This helps it to float on water. And when it reaches to river or seashore, the outer cover decays and the seed is exposed. This way, they grow in distant places. Let's move on to dispersal by animals. Few animals and birds are attracted to bright colored fruits. They eat the entire fruit and only the juicy part is digested by their system. And the seeds are excreted out in the form of their dropping. Birds often swallow some seeds which come out undigested. In this way, birds also aid in the dispersal of seeds. And some seeds like xanthium have hooks, spines or stiff hair. These features help them to get easily stuck to the furry skin of animals, feathers of birds or even to our clothes. And this way, they also help in the dispersal of seeds. You can check that in the given figure. Dispersal by explosion. Explosion in fruits literally refer to bursting with all its energy. In this case, as the fruit gets ripened, it shoots out its seeds. Some fruit like peas, geranium, poppy and balsam burst open when they ripen. The seeds in a pod burst open or explode when dry. The force of explosion helps to scatter these seeds. Fruits like balsam, pea plant are good example of such plants. Children, please read about all the topics which we have discussed just now, given on page number 280, 281 and 282 to understand all the concepts in a better way. Thank you.